So you have two types of flash setups, two main types. So this would be one with a controller. As you can see, these TSOPs I removed from the board. There were four total. We're reading one right now. And this is the controller. And normally what happens when these fail is the controller's firmware is corrupt, or the controller no longer responds, or it puts out invalid data. So on the other hand, then you have monolithic memory, like this guy and this guy. So it's essentially the same thing. You'll have memory chips like this inside of them. They're just very, very small. And you'll also have a controller inside of here. It's very, very small. So you cannot read them individually, where these TSOPs have dedicated pinouts. These pins never change from 8-bit TSOPs. It will change from 16-bit, but they're still the same if they're 16-bit. So you never have to worry about them being any different. Whereas on here, they'll always be different. They may have different pad arrangements. It may have different via arrangements, but they're almost always going to be completely different. So you have to analyze them before you can start reading. Where these, we can start reading, and I know what kind of controller this is, so I have an advantage in the sense of being able to reconstruct it a little quicker than usual. On these, you're flying blind for the most part. This is actually just one piece from a flash drive. Like these have, you know, one or sometimes two chips. They're still small, but this type of monolith is probably going to be as wide as the USB itself. And if you see that blue piece in there, that would be where that starts. And typically they're about that big. And they're used far more frequently now. It's cheaper to manufacture, and people want smaller and easier, more portable devices. First step is shaving off all of the backing, the coating on it. And then once that's done, use a multimeter to figure out which signals may be the data port. It's 8-bit, so you're gonna have 8 that basically range in the same resistance. And then the other ones are sort of a shot in the dark and you're guessing at it. And so then once that's done, I would solder each pad that I've identified that aren't duplicate pads to the areas on here that are 1 through 16. And once that's finished, I will plug in the logic analyzer into the computer and run, pull a scan of each individual pad. That from then on, I can tell by looking at the different signals that come out, I can tell which ones are the 8-bit data ports, as well as figure out where your ALE, CLE, CE0, 1, 2, RE, RB, figure out all those signals. And then after that, I still have to figure out which order the 8 data bits go in. And once I figure that out, then I desolder everything else and resolder it to the exact positioning where you can see now where I have done that. And then I can pull a raw dump. And that's about 25% of the work. And then I gotta still reconstruct it logically. So first you map out 16, and if you need additional pins, for instance, if you have more banks or crystals inside the chip, then you'll do it again and you'll just find out where the other banks or other crystals are located. Since you only have 16 channels on the logic analyzers, you might have to do it multiple times to find more signals. This is just the signals when it first puts power into it the signals that come out of it. So I got to figure out which one is which and then group them into, for instance, I group all the data up here and then I'll name them. Instead of channel 6, I'll name it, you know, IO1, IO2, IO3, IO4, and then, you know, my CEs and RBs all at the bottom. So once I figure that out, then I know where the pins go, and then I remap them on here to this specific signal. But with monoliths, you have to do the logic analysis, then you have to pull the raw data dump, and then put it back together, flying blind, not knowing what type of controller it may be using. You can kind of see some signals that you might get an idea of what manufacturer controller by looking at the raw data and bitmap, but for the most part, you're not gonna know what controller it is, so it's even more work. So you have a raw data dump, and that's not data for the customer. You have to be able to figure out how to turn that into logical blocks and put them in order.